Yes.
Hello there. Say, I couldn't help but notice your house number was 777. Isn't that the number for heaven or something like that? Pretty funny.
Does this look like heaven to you?
I guess not. Anyway, I think there's something wrong with your dog, though.
Did you want something?
Yes, I'm from the Neighborhood Crime Council, and I'm conducting a survey on the recent crime wave. So I just...
Get out of here! 3 nights ago, I was walking down the street, and this little chihuahua followed me. God damn it. It knew. It knew. I started running, and finally I lost it. But God damn it, it knew.
What is this?
I just want to ask you some questions.
Oh, okay then. Ask away.
Is there some place more comfortable we can go and talk?
Oh. Over there.
Is this a bad time? I mean, I could always come back. It's not that important.
Go ahead. I was just working on my new comic, Happy Noodle Boy. It's really popular with the homeless and insane. Just go ahead. Ask me questions. Ask me lots of questions. Go ahead. Sit, please.
Okay. So, I was just wondering, what are your thoughts on the violent crime spree, and what do you think can be done to protect the people?
Well, the violent crimes, all perfectly natural in a society whose advances are limited to its technology. The basic behavior of the modern human is hardly different from that of his primitive ancestors. The only noticeable changes are trends. Whether in a suit or in a loincloth, people are ignorant, little thorns digging into each other. They seem incapable of advancing beyond the violent tendencies with which at one point were necessary for survival. As for protecting the people, well, that's a bit of a paradox, at least from what I know. I'm sure that if you search into the lives of some of these victims, you would find out that they themselves were the cause of their very deaths. In those cases, the so-called victim at some earlier time played some part in the creation of their killer. I believe that the life ended, the fact that it was wasted on something that would never evolve beyond the childish cruelty so many never cast off.
Okay.
Ask another one.
Question number 2. So, what do you think of the ideas that violence on television and other media have the negative effect on kids and their impressionable minds?
Any pile of stunted growth unaware that entertainment is just that and nothing more deserves to doom themselves to some dank cell somewhere for having been so stupid. Movies, books, TV, music, they're all just entertainment, not guidebooks for damning yourself.
These are some fantastic answers you're giving me, but don't worry now. I was nervous at first, but now I'd be glad to ask you a couple more. I've got one, but it's kind of weird. Anyway, remember a night, a couple nights ago, the police found a girl behind the mall? Very strange. She was drained of all her blood. The police think that maybe the killer was some sort of vampire monster. Like he was drinking her blood. What do you think?
I never drank her blood! I needed it! The wall! It changes colors when it dries! It never stays wet!
Ah!
another question. Beautiful night. I think I'll kill myself. What else is there to do? It's so incredibly lovely out. It's not as if anyone's gonna drop by, although on nights like these, I really wish somebody would. I really don't wanna be alone right now. Fuck! Well, this time, I'll make sure there aren't any more! Ever! No more dreaming for real friends. No more stars for me to be alone under. No more! I'm blowing that lid! I'm going over the stars. Something's gone wrong with me! I know that. This place has made me sick. Somehow all I smell is just shit in this diseased reality. All I can see is things full of rot. Riddled with stairs! Time for something new. Over the stars!
Wait! Don't do it. Killing yourself isn't the answer.
Like hell is it now, bunny! You don't know what it's like! You can't even imagine the things I've done.
You bought me at a pet store, fed me once, and then nailed me to this wall 3 years ago. I don't have to imagine, but just listen to me.
Fuck you! You lie! You just want to keep me writhing here on this wrestling blade to keep me here in this place!
You're right. The filthy rabbit is lying, indeedly doodly. The only way out of the pain is through a hole in your head. Your body is the anchor keeping you from flying over the stars.
No, Johnny. He's the liar. You can get help. Please don't do anything stupid. There have to be people out there, somewhere, who can help you, different from the ones who have hurt you. Yes! Yes!
No! Impossible! Too late! I can only see the things I despise! So shut up, please!
Bad, bad lying bunny. You misguide him. Keep silent. Keep silent. Our boy is in need of this cure and it must be taken through the skin. So let him pull the fucking trigger!
No, Johnny. No, you're not crazy. Look, you're not. You and I are having a perfectly sane conversation. Yes?
I guess so. I've been pretty shaken through the years. Maybe you're right. Maybe I can get help.
Johnny C., your infection deludes you. You can wash away every last drop of blood from these walls, but the walls of your mind remain stained forever. You are beyond redemption, that's it. No more.
No! That's it! No more!
Ah! Hey! That commercial where the whole family gets diarrhea is on again.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and ghouls, step right up! Behind this curtain lies a ghastly concoction of delight, horror, fantasy, and terror! Your every wish is our command, your every whimsical desire brought to life. But I'm warning you, there's always a price. Welcome to the greatest show on earth!